Hello, everybody. Welcome into another edition of Talking Fitchburg. It is Tuesday, June 9th, 2020. I hope you had a wonderful day as we set in here for the storm of storms. Well, it's a storm, all right. The remnants of Tropical Storm Cristobal is here, and the rain and storms will be... Well, they'll be here for a while. So I want you to make sure you keep up with the latest on the storm and more. In fact, we're going to check in with my friend Tim Hallback at the National Weather Service, Milwaukee Sullivan. He'll give us a breakdown of the storm from top to bottom. And we'll do that here coming up in our guest segment. We'll also take a look back at a talk with our friend Kendall at All Comfort Services, talking about air conditioning, making sure you're ready to go as well. It's hot out now, so after the last day and a half here, it's been warm out, so you may be thinking maybe it's time we talk about the air conditioning. So we'll take a look back at that as well and then wrap up the show. But first, we do want to talk about the weather, and I want to remind you to check back with the National Weather Service as the situation continues to develop. The information is going to change frequently here, so while this show is... as rebroadcasted over and over again, things will change as the storm changes. So at this point, multiple weather hazards remain with the storm today and tonight. This includes heavy rainfall, gusty winds, strong to severe storms, hazardous beach conditions. Well, yeah, if you're heading towards Lake Michigan today, yeah, not advising you to do any type of swimming as I got some big swells out there coming in. But yeah, there's a chance for heavy rains, thunderstorms, and even a possible tornado. Can't be ruled out today. And these things can spin up really fast as part of the tropical system. So please, please check back in with the National Weather Service and stay up to date on that. Also want to make sure you have a plan. Yeah, a plan when we're talking about flooding. So flooding is definitely a concern with this storm, especially if you're heading out west in Wisconsin. But either way, I want to make sure you have your plan ready to go, a communication plan, assemble your emergency kit if you haven't already. Great resources on readywisconsin.gov. Know your risk, sign up for notifications, be prepared, prepare your home, prepare your family, pets, and charge all of your electronics, make sure you're ready to go, and then stay informed. Get to higher ground if needed, and if evacuations orders are put out there, make sure you adhere to those. Again, expecting rain here. It's been very dry in this area, but can't rule out some flooding from the storm today. So please keep an eye on it and take those warnings seriously if there is a flash flood warning put out there. And again, check back to the Weather Service for more information. All right, reminder that the Fitchburg Business Loan or Boost Loan applications are due Friday, June 12th. Yeah, this is by 4:30 p.m. On Friday, forward Fitchburg Biz Boost Loan Program. It's available to Fitchburg small businesses with 1 to 25 employees. The intent of this loan program is to assist with the costs associated with relaunching business operations with necessary health and safety protocols detailed in the forward Dane reopening plan. And yeah, if you are interested in taking part in this, get yourself signed up for it right now. Again, deadline is coming up on Friday, the 12th here of June. All right, COVID-19 updates, got some for you here. As of this morning, there were 867 people who had been tested positive for COVID-19 in Dane County. That was up 15 from yesterday's update. Of these cases, 5 are from the community test site, 2 are from congregate facilities, or congregate facilities, and the rest are from other sites such as clinics and hospitals. In case you missed it, we released the latest data in the snapshot yesterday that you can check online at publichealthmdc.com/COVID or coronavirus. And there is still free testing available at Alliant Energy Center, so you can check that out. That's Monday through Saturday if you want to get tested. And speaking of that here, we wanted to talk quickly about COVID-19, that it's still out there. And as we start to get back out in the community, we still want you to take the precautions as you head out there. So maybe you're going out to eat. So there is risk with outdoor seating than indoors, or lesser risk, excuse me, of outdoor seating than indoors. Check out their website and call ahead to find out what measures they're taking to reduce the risk. Most businesses are putting stuff up on their Facebook page, so you can check that out. Wear a face covering when bring hand sanitizer wipes. Make sure the surfaces that you touch are clean, no matter where you sit. Dine with just your household and make sure you are seated 6 feet from others. And of course, continue to follow these easy measures every single day. Wash your hands, avoid touching your eyes, nose, mouth with unwashed hands. Stay at home when you are sick. Wear your cloth face mask covering. There's definitely a lot of great resources out there to help you with that. So just know that it's not gone away yet. As things get better and better, and I know the news is getting better and better too, so we're very excited for that. Finally things are opening back up, and we're getting back to whatever our new normal looks like. So very excited for that. All right, that does it for our headlines. Coming up next, we're opening up the digest. We're talking about your air conditioning. That's next, right here on Talking Fitchburg.
We score going to the playoffs.
I can't believe I missed that.
Every time I'm buzzed, I spend too much time on my phone. What? I should take your phone away.
No. I'll call for a ride. Hey, why does my face look like that?
I'm playing with these new face filters.
Okay, you know what?
Yep, that's mine.
Kevin, I need that back.
No.
Kevin!
Gaining weight was easy. All I had to do was sit down and eat. Losing weight's a lot harder. I have to work at it every day. But with every step, I lower my risk for type 2 diabetes and heart disease. And that makes every step, every choice, every day very much worth the effort.
Learn how you can help stop diabetes by losing weight, eating healthy, and staying active. Visit checkupamerica.org or call 1-800-DIABETES.
Welcome back into Talking Fitchburg. Joining me today is Kendall from All Comfort Services. He's here to get us ready for spring. As we had you on last year around this time, probably even a little bit earlier, but it's that time to start thinking about the air conditioning. We've been getting some nice days here, and how we doing?
We're doing well. We're out there already doing a lot of maintenance on homes. Last time we talked a little bit about the protective wear that we're wearing to make sure people are comfortable, masks, gloves, social distancing, those type of things. But we've been doing a lot of maintenances and even some installations of air conditioners.
Yeah, it is getting to that time of the season. Real quick, Kendall, if you could just remind our viewers that, again, most contractors, including yourself, are practicing social distancing and making sure that when you do come out to the houses and the homes, you are doing your part to keep everybody safe from the time you walk in to the time you leave.
Absolutely. Our team members wear gloves. We got a mask, so they wear a mask when they're customer facing, if not all the time. And we wear booties, we spray down, surfaces that we touch, finding disinfectant wipes. That's probably our biggest challenge right now. Gloves, maybe a little bit, but we took care of the mask by, making an investment in our team members, and our customers, quite frankly.
Yeah, no, I think that's good information to hear. We know things are fast changing in this world, and, it's good to hear on your part that, you guys will take the steps as well to keep people safe. Transitioning here now, tough one to transition to, as we look into kicking on those air conditioning units outside the homes, as we're getting the prep going here, take me step by step, Kendall, on what we should be doing as we roll into the warm season.
So I'll hit a couple topics. People ask us all the time. I got asked yesterday about covering an AC, putting a cover over. We don't recommend it. We don't think it's bad. It's just kind of unnecessary from our point of view. But if you do cover it, make sure you take the cover off. Hopefully you've taken the cover off a little bit ago. The only thing that we do recommend is if you're worried about icicles that are over the outside part of the air conditioner, the condenser, maybe to put a piece of plywood over it with a heavy brick. So icicles that drop down don't do damage. So you want to make sure the outside unit is free from, you know, all debris and a cover or that, you know, plywood if you do that. But the most important thing I can say today is maybe not today, but Thursday or Friday, certainly Saturday, I think it's going to be in the 70s, turn your air conditioner on. I don't care if you don't normally turn on until it's 98. Turn it on, make sure it works, run it for like 15 or 20 minutes. You know, that little piece of advice, if you follow it, will save you potentially a lot of frustration, because that day when you want it to work and it does not come on, you know, you'll be kicking yourself in the butt, because at that point, you know, probably a lot of, you know, other people like me and like you that haven't done that in the past necessarily will be turning on the air conditioner and it won't start, and then they're calling. And then it's a hard time for us and all the other companies to reach out and get to people quickly. So just take, you know, on Friday or Saturday, just take, you know, 20 minutes, you know, turn on your air conditioner, call for cooling. So drop it down below the temperature in the house and make sure, you know, cold air is coming out. You'll be glad you did it.
Yeah, I took your advice last year on that and turned it on, and my fan didn't spin outside on the unit, and I was like, oh, surprise.
Sorry, but I'm glad.
Right?
Sorry.
No, yeah. I'm glad I did too, because having it on a day when you would need it definitely would be a concern. Moving to the inside, Kendall, and down there, if everything is running well, I know changing the filter becomes a really important piece as well.
Right, having a quality filter, you know, I'll generically say there's 1-inch and there's 5-inch filters, and here is a 5-inch filter to give you an idea. I'll get that right. It's a MERV 16, so a high-end filter. If you have a 4 or 5-inch filter, you know, you need to change out once a year. Probably now is a great time to change it out, just because of what's going on. I would just take the opportunity to change out and not worry about it for a year. You know, when we do maintenance on the air conditioner, and us and every other company that does a good job, not only are we working on the outside unit, we are in the basement and at the thermostat. So, you know, full disclosure, occasionally a customer will think, oh, come out and do the maintenance. You're just outside, right? And then we have to explain them, really, to do the job that we want to do, we have to be inside, you know, at the furnace and the inside part of the air conditioner, as well as at the thermostat. We have kind of a policy of, what do we call it? We call it I'm getting the right verbiage here, but it's kind of a no touch, no contact, sorry, no contact job. You know, we contact equipment, but not the customer at all, and we wipe down all the, you know, equipment that we're touching while in the house. So, but that is important for, you know, homeowners to understand. Not only are we outside, but we're in the basement, if that's where your system is, and at the thermostat for just a little bit. But, you know, we wear masks when customer facing, gloves, and then we wipe down surfaces as well.
Yeah, Kendall, what would be some of the common things that maybe would give out as the years go on with your system, things that you could be prepared for? I know that's a very loaded question, mind you, but what are some things that tend to be a repair in the springtime for you guys when you're looking at typical maintenance?
So thank you for that softball here. One comment I would make is, if your system is over 15 to 20 years old, I just gotta let you know, the systems that are out now are probably about 30 to 50% more efficient. So if you're a big user of the air conditioner and you have an older system, you're gonna save some money, you know, on replacing it and save some energy as well. So that's probably the one comment. I wouldn't say that necessarily about a furnace. You know, it's a little different. So, but there really has been some pretty good strides in the last 15 years on efficiency of air conditioners. So, but, you know, contactors, capacitors, you know, sometimes, you know, air conditioners have an issue with that. You know, I think once you start to put in, you know, over $600 on an older piece of equipment, you know, you may want to talk to them about the options of replacing. But, you know, contactors and capacitors are generally below that. Condenser fan motor, you know, you mentioned about your blades not turning. Generally, it's the condenser fan motor. Sometimes it's both the blades and the condenser fan motor, and that's a pretty good investment. So you know, may want to, you know, to make a good informed decision, may want to look at your options at that point. But those are the main concerns that happen. You know, a clean filter is important. Occasionally, people will turn the breaker off. So if your AC doesn't turn on right away, you know, maybe think, hey, did I decide to turn the AC off? The breaker for the AC off last fall. We don't recommend it, but, you know, we understand that that some people feel more comfortable with that. So occasionally people will have us out and figure out that, No, they just didn't turn the breaker on, so we go ahead and do the maintenance while we're there.
Yeah, final question for you, Kendall, and I want you to get out your glass ball here, looking into the future.
Okay.
How do you determine for replacement of a furnace? So, you know, in my case, moved in the house a couple of years ago. I think the house is over 20 years old. I'm not sure if it is the original system or not, but how would you plan out that, you know, from your side of things, that your recommendations for replacing or getting a new system, whether it is heating or cooling?
So two softballs in a row here. You know, it is difficult. I mean, we try to treat our customers just like friends and family. One thing I would say is before I spent, you know, over $700 on an older system, and older, you know, nowadays could be as young as 10 to 12 years on any construction build type piece of equipment. But, you know, anything when you're spending some money, probably looking at your options there. As far as being proactive, it depends on the person, but for peace of mind, if you're like, you know what, I don't want to worry about this going down, or I don't like the way it works. I would say, you know, somewhere in that 15 to 18 years is probably where that window opens up to say, hey, it's working fine, but I want to be proactive. That silver lining is with an air conditioner, you're going to save a lot of money on energy. With that furnace, if it's high efficiency furnace, so it comes out in the PVC, 2-inch pipe that, you know, comes out the top of the furnace and out the side of the house or the roof of the house, you know, it's probably fairly efficient. And you know, there's some savings to be made on the electrical side, but not huge dollars. If it's doing a great job for you, you know, that maybe you wait until you have to make that investment. Doing a furnace and an AC together, there are a lot of good reasons to do it. It's not necessary, but you know, if we're dealing with a furnace that's 15 years old and there's a major part repair and that, you know, that AC is the same age, we're actually asking that customer and educating that customer, on what are the advantages of doing both the furnace and the AC, replacing both the furnace and the AC at the same time. There's federal tax credits that came out. There's focus on energy that's funded by the state of Wisconsin. And quite frankly, there's just savings to do them together as compared to doing one now and one, you know, in the fall. I mean, you just save some money. So it's significant. I mean, with all that, it could be as high as $1,500 of savings to do them together, you know, and that's not, you know, buying the top of the end equipment. I mean, just, you know, by the time you get the federal tax credit, focus on energy and our savings together to do them together, it makes a big difference.
Yeah, no, I appreciate it. I know it's a tough question, but a good information as well to share with folks and trying to make that decision, because I think, you know, as you come into the spring, you're like, man, half good last year, we put some money into it. But kind of pulling that plan together of, you know, what what and how and when to do that, I think is important. So I appreciate it, Kendall. And I suspect we could probably even spend more time just talking on that front alone.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. But yeah, if anyone has any questions, just give us a call here at All Comfort Services.
All right, Kendall, thank you so much for your time as always. And we'll look forward to talking to you down the road here. And please for we hope you and your family stay safe out there during this time.
Thanks, Jeremy.
All right. That's Kendall from All Comfort Services. So you can give them a call, but just do that check. Start checking now. Don't wait until it gets too warm out and you fire that thing up and be disappointed. Not a good thing. All right, we'll take a quick break. You are watching Talking Fitchburg.
Hola, Julia. ¿Estás lista para tocar con nosotros? Yo tocaré mi clarinete.
¿Quién no tocará su tambor?
Tambor ruidoso.
Bueno, ya sabes qué hacer, Julia.
Julia sabe.
Dado el autismo de Julia, los sonidos pueden ser muy fuertes.
Y hace música a su manera.
¡A tocar!
La detección temprana del autismo puede hacer una diferencia de por vida. Conoce más sobre la detección temprana en detecciondeautismo.org.
Our hearts are made stronger by how we treat others.
Put her there.
The light you share can impact those around you, but so can the darkness.
Later, twerps!
Did Pete saying mean things bother
you? So when you reach out to another person, take a moment to consider how they will feel and let your heart be the key to making a difference. Because of you, someone's entire day, year, or even life can change.
In every heart, there's hope.
Welcome back into Talking Fitchburg. Joining me today from the National Weather Service, Milwaukee Sullivan, it's Tim Halbach. Tim, how are you doing today?
Not too bad. How are you guys doing?
Hanging in there. Tim, I can't say in my lifetime that I ever thought while I was doing Talking Fitchburg that I would be talking about Tropical Storm in Wisconsin. A very rare thing. Tim, what's the history behind this? And tell us a little bit about what's going on.
Yeah, so this is, at this point, the kind of the remnants of the tropical system. I don't think we'd ever get like a true hurricane or tropical storm to be able to hold on over land for this long. But when something like this happens, it pulls a lot of that moisture and tropical air mass that you would typically see down by the Gulf of Mexico and brings it all the way up into our area. So pretty rare, I think, based on our records. There's been only two that have gone across Wisconsin's land, and then we had another one that's technically in Wisconsin's Lake Michigan ownership area that have come across. So we're just in the right weather pattern right now where this thing, instead of, you know, normally it'd kind of go across the south and then track towards the Atlantic, the right path that is just coming straight up into southern Wisconsin. So along with that, it's bringing all the different weather hazards that we typically see with a tropical disturbance, where just very efficient rainfall producing, which could lead to some flooding. Some quick spin up tornadoes are not out of the realm of possibilities. So those are some of the things we're looking at. And on top of that, also high winds as well, you know, possible or gusty winds as well. So a lot going on with this for the next few days here.
Tim, talk about how the storm track for tracking this, because it's complicated, in fact, for a hurricane. And I apologize for my kids in the background. They're like many, many hurricanes. Talk about, as far as tracking goes, how hard is it to track something like this in general? And then we're trying to track this coming from the south here.
Yeah, it's a little bit tougher than normal weather systems. You kind of relate it to what happens with winter storms, where if it just takes a little bit of a kind of a jaunt one way or another, it can mean some pretty big differences with who gets the heavy rainfall. So that's one of the things that we're trying to look at and trying to nail down today. Some of the latest trends are that it's going a little bit further east than what it previously had been progged. So more of southwestern Wisconsin going up through north central Wisconsin, more in sights to see some of the heavier rainfall from this. So that's some of the trickier stuff that we tend to see, because a lot of those impacts depend on where it tracks and what time of day it gets into our part of the state.
Yeah, and then let's talk a little bit about some of the stuff that you're expecting from this. Spin-up tornadoes, how would you describe that that scenario?
Yeah, so with a hurricane or this tropical disturbance like this, the wind field is really just right for you get, you know, like a normal thunderstorm, you can get a little spin up. Sometimes we see this with some of the bands that circulate around the center of the system. Sometimes it's right next to where it is. So those conditions that we typically look at for tornadoes developing are a little bit ideal for this. It's just some of the other ingredients that might not line up with, you know, how unstable the atmosphere is and whether or not we're going to get, you know, some bigger storms from it. So it's a little bit different scenario than our typical summertime thunderstorms. You know, it's not going to be something where we have a long track tornado path, but we can't rule out at least a brief tornado like that.
And then with the gusty winds and the rain, obviously probably a bigger threat here for the storm today. Will we see winds like steady? So is it going to be like a steady at 20 with gusts of 30, 40? Is it, how does that play out? And then I will follow up with the rainfall question.
Yeah, so with the winds, it's going to be more of a steady, you know, 20, 30 mile per hour type wind. But then within, if we do get some of this rain, there are some stronger winds that are just above the ground that if you get any of those, you know, downdrafts, you know, pushing some of that wind down to the ground, you could see some of those higher gusts within some of the storms as they come through late this afternoon and through this evening. So that's kind of what we're looking at. Not like a, you know, onshore hurricane where you got 100 plus mile per hour winds. But still, you'll see the winds pick up here.
Okay. All right. And then real quick on the rainfall, which can be deadly, as we know. Are we expecting where there could be pockets where it could get 5, 6, 7 inches in an hour type of scenario? Or is this more of a long drawn out piece?
It looks like it would be not just like in an hour. It would be over a number of hours where you just get this very efficient rainfall over a small amount of time. The good thing that we have going for us right now is that the system is moving along fairly quickly. So if it were to stall out, just sit there, that'd be much more of a concern for getting those higher 5, 6, 7 inch rainfall totals. So right now our estimates are generally about in that 2 to 3 inch range with some locally higher amounts. Unfortunately, it's going to fall over a lot of areas where there is a little bit more terrain that if it all runs off, that you can get some flooding in some of the rivers and creeks and streams. Thankfully, we've been fairly dry for the past week or so, so the ground should be able to soak up some of this. It's just a matter of if it all comes in one little chunk that we would see that flash flooding. So that's why there's a flash flood watch out for tonight going through tomorrow morning.
It's a crazy weather event, something that will go down in the history books for sure, Tim. For folks tonight wanting to keep up on things from your perspective, tell them how they can stay up to date or what you would recommend for safety tonight in keeping up with the weather service.
Yeah, so all of our information's online. Weather.gov is the main website. You can go to each individual weather service offices. So we cover from the Dells down through Lafayette County and east. The La Crosse office is in the western Wisconsin. So there's different offices that cover the state. Weather.gov will get you to where the main updated information is more recently. Just if you have to be driving tonight, watch for any low flooded roadways. A lot of people that die from flash flood is because they've driven into a flooded roadway. It might not seem as deep as what it actually is, so just watch for those flooded crossroads, particularly if it's kind of like a low area that you'd be driving through. So that's probably the main thing to make people aware of for tonight.
Fantastic. Tim, thank you so very much for your time. I know it's busy with tracking the storm in today. Good luck, and we'll be keeping up to date with what's going on, and looking forward to following up with you soon.
All right. Thanks, Jeremy.
All right. Tim Halbach, National Weather Service, Milwaukee Sullivan. They will be busy keeping you up to date on what's happening with this storm and the rest of the storms throughout the summer. We'll take a quick break. You are watching Talking Fitchburg.
See on page 4 that the projections need to be flood next Thursday.
Seriously? Thursday? Can't do that.
This is really inconvenient.
I have yoga that day.
I have no time for this. So
I can't do Thursday, but I can do Friday.
Disasters? Don't plan ahead. You can. Talk to your loved ones about how you're going to be ready in an emergency. Don't wait. Communicate.
Hero, I see your light in the dark, smile in my face when we all know it's hard. You're doing a good job, you're doing a good job. Don't get too down, the world needs you now, know that you matter.
Welcome back into Talking Fitchburg, wrapping up the show for the day. Remember to check back to the National Weather Service, Milwaukee Sullivan. Stay up to date on the latest on this storm. And thank you to Tim Halbach for joining us today and helping us get the information out about the weather. All right, stay connected with Fact TV when you're not checking the weather service like I am always. And you can check us out on, of course, Facebook, YouTube, and Apple TV and Roku. Have a safe night, everybody. Turn those weather radios up. We'll see you tomorrow.